Now, folks, this is a deer with a lot of mass. And that's one of the things that I admire in an animal. The beings here, as you can see, are very, very massive all the way out. And John, what can you tell us about your hunt?
I've seen three of them, and one in every. I took this one. It's the only chance I've had. Big bass hunt.
I hear you.
Fourth Thanksgiving this year.
Yeah, right, so that was a rutting buck. Very, very good. Well, he's a beautiful deer. Hold that up, folks. Let's give him a big hand, please. Congratulations. Now we're going to go to the Indiana archery typicals. And Indiana stepped up in a big way this year. Matter of fact, they're first and second place in archery. Eclipsed Kentucky this year. First place goes to Neil Bison. Neil Ballou. Sorry about that, bro. Now, folks, this is a deer that is very, very impressive for several reasons. As Harold just said, look at the eye guards. This thing's got brow tines that are bigger than the tines on most giant bucks. Obviously, beautiful symmetry in the rack. And from look at this mount, this had to be a whopper. Did you weigh this deer?
240.
240 pounds. Well, he shows every bit of it. Tell us a little bit about this deer.
Well, he busted me the year before last day of bow season, and went back to the same tree on the 29th of October. Came right through about a half hour before dark, and 20 yards, and hit the ground. So can't complain about that.
Did you shake before, during, or after?
Oh, the whole time.
Very good. I think this is an absolutely beautiful deer. If you would, hold it up, and we'll get a few pictures for you. Let's give him a hand, folks. Second place in the Indiana Archery Typical Division, and this was close. This is a deer that scored 160 and a half. Blake Duzer. Blake? He's carrying him 2x2. Harold, I'll let you talk about this one. He's got it all.
Well, I'm looking at how long his tines were. You'd ask me which one of these deer I shot, and I told you, 6-1, half dozen of them.
Absolutely. They're which all ever, magnificent.
They both are great deer. That's great. This has got an eye going right here. They're pretty symmetrical. That's a great deer. Long tines. I like that.
He was a tree shredder, is what I call bucks with antlers like that. I bet you he was leaving some big rubs. Did you know this buck was where you were hunting?
Yeah, we'd actually had this one on camera for 3 years and missed him that whole gun season, but got him the last late archery season, last week of December.
Is that right? Well, that's fabulous. Hold that deer up. We'll get you some nice pictures. Give him a big hand, folks. Okay, we're going to move forward to Kentucky Firearms Typical category. First place goes to John Payne, 159 and 3/8. John? Woo. These deer give me an inferiority complex, Harold. Oh, these are whopper bucks. What can you tell us about this deer?
Well, this was an archery hunt that turned into a rifle hunt. He hunted up, I just don't know how fast a deer like this, but I have a rifle on the tree. He hunted up at 60 yards, and I just had to shoot him with the rifle.
Understand that plan. Did you know the deer was in the area?
Yes, sir. We've watched him since he was little.
I'll be darned. You know, it's a special thing to me to hear him kill a buck that you know's there. and doing with that deer.
I used to screw it up the only way if I was there.
Yeah.
Is this your biggest buck in? He's going to play football for the University of Louisville. He's kicking.
Oh, is that right?
I'm mistaken, is that right? And I tell you what, it's going right along the deer.
Absolutely.
Right on track. I tell you, that is a great deer.
Do what you gotta do.
That's right. I
think
practice. That's football season.
Well, hold that deer up so everybody can get a good shot of that thing. It's another beautiful, beautiful buck. Congratulations, John. Second place, Kentucky Firearms Typical, goes to Joe Morris, 123 and a quarter. Joe?